So how are we calculating this indicator? So the most important thing is to start with the K line, which is the one that is marked by the blue arrow on the previous slide. The previous slide was this. So the K line, the blue line, it equals to, take a look at this, current close minus lowest close. The result of this, you divide it by the highest high minus the lowest low. Multiply all of this by 100. And this is for the respective period that is taken into consideration. Also, notice that this is a standard K line. If there is a smoothing or a slowdown, you should be taking it into consideration and adding it to this formula if there is any. So, and then the D line is a three-period simple moving average of the K line. So basically, the K line is the stochastic line, and the D line is a simple, just a standard three-period simple moving average by default. So that's what it is. This is why the red line was lagging behind the blue line that they create crossovers. The reason for this is that it's simply a three-period simple moving average, nothing more. Notice that I placed some stars during the at the formula. A star at the lowest low, couple stars at the highest high, and three stars on 100. And now I'm going to explain each of these three things one by one. First, I would like to tell you what is the lowest low. Lowest low is the lowest point of the respective look back period. So if you're taking a certain period or a certain that is like marked by a certain candlestick on the chart, the lowest point of it usually located at the lowest candlestick, if there is any, because sometimes there is no low candlestick, you know. If the candle is, for example, Mariboso candle or whatever, there is no low candlestick. But the lowest point, the lowest low of a period is the lowest point of the look back period. Then highest high is exactly the same thing, but opposite. Highest high is the highest point of the look back period. Same. It most of the cases is the upper candle wick of a respective period on the chart. And then the 100, I would like to explain to you why are we multiplying by 100. So the multiplication of the key, of the K by 100 is made to move the decimal points with like with two signs. This is the purpose of the 100. Otherwise, we were going to receive like a big number, you know? So this is why they're multiplying by 100.